Good morning, students. My name is Ankit Dalela, Assistant Professor, Electronics and Communication Department, PVT University, Lucknow. We will continue with the topic bit manipulation instructions in the subject microprocessor and interfacing. The first instruction is SHL DES, count. It shifts bits of bytes or word left by count. It puts zeros in LSBs. MSB is shifted into carry flag. If the number of bits desired to be shifted is 1, then the immediate number can be written in count. However, if the number of bits to be shifted is more than 1, then the count is put in CL register. It means this instruction shifts each bit of operand left by specified number of bits. This instruction shifts each bit of operand which is contained in an 8-bit or 16-bit register or memory locations left by specified number of bits. 0 is put in LSB position. The MSB of the operand is shifted into carry flag. In the case of multi-bit shift, the carry flag contains the most recently shifted bit from the MSB position. If the count is 1, it is specified in the instruction itself. If the count is more than 1, it is specified by the content of CL register. Flags affected are OF, SF, ZF, PF, and CF. AF is undefined. Some examples are SAL AL, 1, SAL AX, 1, SAL AX, CL. Now SAL AX, CL shifts the content of AX left by the number of bits specified by the count contained in CL. Next is SHR DES, count. SHR shifts bits of bytes of word write by count. It puts zeros in MSBs. LSB is shifted into carry flag. If the number of bits desired to be shifted is 1, then the immediate number 1 can be written in count. However, if the number of bits to be shifted is more than 1, then the count is put in CL register. Similarly, this is also this instruction also shifts each bit of operand write by specified number of bits and puts zeros in MSBs, which is contained in an 8-bit or 16-bit register or memory location. The LSB bit is shifted into carry flag. 0 is put in MSB position. In the case of multi-bit shift, the carry flag contains the most recently shifted bit from LSB. If the count is 1, it is specified in the instruction itself. If the count is more than 1, it is specified by the content of CL register. The flags affected are OF, SF, ZF, PF, and CF. And AF is undefined. Example, SHR AX, 1, SHR AX, CL. Next is ROL. ROL DES, count. It rotates bits of bytes or word left by count. MSB is transferred to LSB. If the number of bits desired to be shifted is 1, then the immediate number 1 can be written in count. However, if the number of bits to be shifted is more than 1, then the count is put in CL register. This instruction rotates all bits of the operand contained in an 8-bit or 16-bit register or memory location left by specified number of bits. The MSB of the operand moves to the LSB position of the operand as well as to the carry flag. All other bits of the operand also move 1 or more in case of multi-bit rotation bit left. In case of multi-bit rotation, the carry flag contains the bit most recently moved out of the MSB. If the count is 1, it is specified in the instruction itself. If the count is more than 1, it is specified by the content of CL register. Only CF and OF are affected. Some examples are ROL AL, 1, ROL AX, 1, ROL AX, CL. Next is ROR DES, count. It rotates bits of byte or word right by count. LSB is transferred to MSB and also to CF. If the number of bits desired to be shifted is 1, then the immediate number 1 can be written in count. However, if the number of bits to be shifted is more than 1, then the count is put in CL register. This instruction rotates all bits of the operand contained in an 8-bit or 16-bit register or memory locations right by specified number of bits. The LSB of the operand moves to the MSB position as well as to the carry flag. All other bits of the operand also move 1-bit right. If the count is 1, it is specified in the instruction itself. If the count is more than 1, it is specified by the content of the CL register. Only CF and OF flags are affected. Example, ROR AL, 1, ROR AX, 1, ROR AX, CL. Now comes the program execution transfer instruction. These instructions, there are also some instructions called rotate operand with carry, which is RCL, REG, memory, count. Now this instruction rotates all bits of the operand contained in an 8-bit or 16-bit register or memory location left by specified number of bits through carry flag. The MSB of the operand moves to the carry flag and the bit in the carry flag moves to the LSB position of the operand. All other bits of the operand also move 1-bit left. If the count is 1, it is specified in the instruction itself. If the count is more than 1, it is specified by the content of CL register. Only CF and OF flags are affected. Example, RCL AX, 1, RCL AX, CL, RCL AL, 1. And one more instruction is RCR, which rotates all the bits of the operand right to carry flag by specified number of bits. This instruction rotates all the bits of the operand contained in an 8-bit or 16-bit register or memory location right by specified number of bits through carry flag. The LSB of the operand moves to the carry flag and the bit in the carry flag moves to the MSB position of the operand. All other bits of the operand also move 1-bit right. If the count is 1, it is specified in the instruction itself. If the count is more than 1, it is specified by the content of CL register. Only CF and OF flags are affected. Example, RCR AL, 1, RCR AX, 1, and RCR AX, CL. Now, program execution transfer instructions. These instructions cause change in the sequence of the execution of instruction. This change can be through a condition or sometimes unconditional. The conditions are represented by the flags. You can see the two instructions call and RET, which is call and return. Call instruction is used to call a subroutine or function or procedure. The address of next instruction after call is saved into stack. The call instruction transfers program execution to a procedure or subprogram. The first format is call address, which is an intra-segment or far call. This instruction calls a procedure whose address is given in the instruction. The specified address is of 4 bytes, 2 bytes are for the new value of the content of IP register and 2 bytes for the new value of the content of CS register. When processor executes this instruction, IP and CS values for the next instruction of the program are saved in the stack. The new values of IP and CS are obtained from the call instruction to execute the procedure. Its machine code is 9A and the flags affected are none. Now comes call memory, which is inter-segment or far call. The content of memory specified in the instruction gives the new values for IP and CS. Two memory locations give new value for IP. Next two memory locations give new value for CS and no flags are affected. Now call DISP16, which is intra-segment or near call. The effective address of the procedure is the sum of 16-bit unsigned displacement specified in the instruction and the content of IP. Its machine code is E8 and no flags are affected. And the last call instruction is call memory / register, which is intra-segment or near call. The content of the specified register or memory location gives new value of IP and no flags are affected. Now comes the return instruction. It returns the control from procedure to calling program. Every call instruction should have a return. The return instruction returns program execution from a procedure or subroutine to the next instruction after the call instruction, which calls the procedure. It is the last instruction executed in the procedure and the returns control to the calling program. There are four types of return instructions. First is RET machine code :CB, which returns from subroutine and is inter-segment. This instruction pops top two stack bytes into IP register. These two bytes give the offset address of the next instruction to be executed. This instruction also pops next two bytes into CS register. These two bytes give the code segment address of the next instruction to be executed. In other words, this instruction restores IP and CS from the stack and no flags are affected. Next is RET code :C3, which is returned from subroutine and is intra-segment. This instruction restores IP register from the stack. These values give the offset address of the next instruction to be executed and no flags are affected. Next is RET DISP16, which is inter-segment. Its machine code is CA. This instruction restores IP and CS from the stack. The contents of IP and CS give the offset address and code segment address of the next instruction to be executed respectively. The 16-bit unsigned displacement is added to the stack pointer. This has the effect of adjusting the stack pointer past parameters that might have been placed onto the stack prior to the call that corresponds to this RET. No flags are affected. Next is RET DISP16, which is intra-segment. This instruction restores IP. This value of IP gives the offset address of the next instruction to be executed. Further, 16-bit unsigned displacement is added to the stack pointer. This has the effect of adjusting stack pointer past parameters that might have been placed onto the stack prior to the call that corresponds to this RET. No flags are affected. Last format is IRET, which is return from interrupt service subroutine. This instruction is used to return the program execution from an interrupt service subroutine to the main program. It pops up two stack bytes into IP register. These two bytes give the offset address of the next instruction to be executed. Further, Next two stack bytes are popped into CS register. These two bytes provide the code segment address of the next instruction to be executed. Next two stack bytes are popped into the flag register to restore the flag settings which were before an interrupt occurred. Now comes jump instruction. This instruction is used for unconditional jump from one place to another. While executing a program, it is desired to jump the program execution from one point to the other when certain condition is satisfied. Such jump instructions are called conditional jump. Sometimes unconditional jump is also needed. This type of jump instruction is called unconditional jump. Jump instructions of 8086 are these JA, JAE, JB, JBE, JC, JE, JNC, JNE, JNZ, JPE, JPO, and JZ. So you can see some condition is given in each and every instruction. First is JA. These JA and JNBE, these two instructions are same. Either JA or JNBE causes program execution to jump to the label address given in the instruction if CF and ZF both are zero. The 8-bit displacement is a signed 8-bit displacement. The jump must be in the range of minus 128 bytes to plus 127 bytes. The terms given are used when we consider the magnitude of two unsigned numbers. Next is JAE, which is jump if above or equal, JNB, jump if not below, JNC, jump if no carry. Any one of these instructions causes program execution to jump to the label given in the instruction if CF is zero. The range of displacement is minus 128 bytes to plus 127 bytes. And these terms are used when we consider the magnitude of two unsigned numbers. Next is JB, which is jump if below, that is CF equal to 1. JNAE, which is jump if not above or equal when CF equal to 1. JC, jump if carry when CF equal to 1. So these terms are used when we consider the magnitude of two unsigned numbers and no flags are affected. Next is JBE, which is jump if below or equal, that is when CF and ZF both are equal to 1. JNA, jump if not above, that is when CF and ZF both are equal to 1. These terms are used when we consider the magnitude of two unsigned numbers and no flags are affected. Next is JCXZ, which is jump if CX register is 0. JE, jump if equal, that is when ZF equal to 1. JZ, jump if 0, that is when ZF equal to 1. JG, jump if greater, that is when ZF equal to 0 and CF equal to 0F. JNLE, jump if not less than or equal. These instructions are usually used after a compare instruction. The terms greater and less are used while considering two signed numbers. The term greater means more positive. Here, greater means more positive. The signed number 00000101 positive is greater than the signed number 1111001, which is negative, and no flags are affected. So these were the jump instructions. Next is loop DES. This is a looping instruction. The number of times looping is required is placed in the CX register. With each iteration, the contents of CX are decremented. ZF is checked whether to loop again or not. The instruction loop is used to repeat a sequence of instructions for the specified number of times. The number of times the specified sequence is to be repeated is stored in CX register. Each time the loop instruction is executed, the CX register is automatically decremented without affecting any conditional flag. If the CX register is not zero, the program execution jumps to the specified label. When CX becomes zero, the execution continues to the next instruction after the loop instruction. Now comes loop Z or loop E. Loop Z and loop E are two mnemonics for the same instruction. This instruction is used to repeat a sequence of instructions for the specified number of times until CX is equal to zero or until the zero flag becomes zero. The CX contains the loop count. For repetition of the loop, both conditions CX not equal to zero and ZF equal to one are to be specified, satisfied. If any one of them is not satisfied, the program execution will continue to the next instruction after the loop Z or loop E instruction. Now comes loop NZ or loop NE. Both these two mnemonics are for the same instruction. This instruction is used to repeat a sequence of instructions for the specified number of times, that is until CX equal to zero or until the zero flag becomes one. The CX contains the loop count. For a repetition of the loop, both conditions CX not equal to zero and ZF equal to zero are to be satisfied. If any one of them is not satisfied, that is if CX is equal to zero after the auto decrement or if ZF equal to one, the program execution will simply go to the next instruction after loop NZ or loop NE instruction. Now comes processor control instructions. These instructions control the processor itself. 8086 allows to control certain flags that causes the processing in a certain direction, processor synchronization if more than one microprocessor is attached. The first is STC, which is it sets the carry flag to one and no other flags are affected. Next is CLC. It clears the carry flag to zero. This instruction resets the carry flag to zero and no other flags are affected. Next is CMC. It complements the carry flag. This instruction takes complement of the carry flag. If CF is equal to zero, this instruction sets it to one. If CF equal to one, this instruction resets it to zero. Other flags are not affected. STD. It sets the direction flag to one, and if it is set, string bytes are accessed from higher memory address to lower memory address, and no other flags are affected. Then CLD, it clears the direction flag to zero. If it is reset, the string bytes are accessed from lower memory address to higher memory address. So this instruction resets the direction flag to zero and no other flags are affected. STI, it sets the interrupt flag to one to enable INTR interrupt and no other flags are affected. Next is HLT, which is halt processing. This instruction stops program execution. The processor stops fetching and executing instructions. The processor enters a halt stage and it will come out of halt state only when one of the following event occurs: an interrupt signal on INTR line, an interrupt signal on NMI line, a reset signal on a reset input. Next is NOP, which is no operation. This instruction performs no operation. It takes three clock cycles and increments instruction pointer to point to the next instruction. It can be used to produce delay before executing certain instructions. Next is ESC, which is escape. This instruction makes bus free from external master like a coprocessor or peripheral device. It performs no operation as far as the 8086 is concerned. It allows coprocessor to receive its instructions from 8086 instruction stream. Next is wait. The processor enters an idle state. When wait instruction is executed, the processor enters an idle state in which The processor 8086 does no processing. The processor remains in the idle state until test pin is made low or until INTR or NMI interrupt occurs. After executing interrupt service subroutine, the processor again returns to the idle state because the address of wait instruction is pushed on the stack when the processor responds to the interrupt request. Wait instruction is used to synchronize the 8086 with external hardware such as the 8087 math coprocessor. Last instruction is lock. It makes lock pin low. So lock is an active low pin. It is a prefix instruction. It makes lock bar pin low till the execution of the next instruction. When lock bar is low, no other processor can take the control of the system bus in a multiprocessor system. Now comes the string instructions. String is an assembly in assembly language is just a sequentially stored bytes or words. There are very strong set of string instructions in 8086. By using these string instructions, the size of the program is considerably reduced. First is CMPS. This is a string instruction. It compares the contents of the string bytes or words. It compares the content of location addressed by DI register with the content of location addressed by SI register. For comparison, the content of location addressed by DI register is subtracted from the content of memory location addressed by SI register. The result is not stored. Both operands remain unaffected. SI and DI register are automatically incremented or decremented to point to the next elements in the two strings after the execution of the instruction if the DF flag is 0 or 1. CMPSB is for byte operation. For byte operation, SI and DI are incremented or decremented by 1. The instruction CMPSW is for word operation. SI and DI are incremented or decremented by 2 for word operation. Object codes for CMPSB and CMPSW are A6 and A7. CMPS instruction can be used with REPE or REPNE prefix to compare all the elements of a string. The register CX is used as counter. The string addressed by DI register must be an extra segment. The string addressed by SI register must be in data segment. All conditional flags are effective. Next is SCAS string. It scans a string. It compares the string with byte in AL or with word in AX. It compares the content of the accumulator with the content of the location addressed by DI register in the extra segment. The string to be scanned must be in extra segment. The DI register contains the offset of the operand to be compared. After the execution of the instruction, the DI register is automatically incremented or decremented if the direction flag is 0 or 1. This instruction is used for a repeat instruction prefix to compare all the elements of a string. For example, REPNE prefix can be used when a match in the string is to be searched. When match is found in the string, execution stops. The CX register is used as a counter. For byte scanning, SCASB instruction is used. For word scanning, SCASW instruction is used. For comparison, the content of memory location addressed by DI register is subtracted from the content of the accumulator. Flags are set according to the result, but the result is not stored. The content of the accumulator as well as the content of the memory location remain unchanged. The flags affected are OF, SF, ZF, AF, PF, and CF respectively. Next is MOVS, MOVSB, MOVSW. It causes moving of byte or word from one string to another. In this instruction, the source string is in data segment and the destination string is in extra segment. SI and DI store the offset values for source and destination index. MOVES instruction moves 8-bit or 16-bit data from location addressed by SI register to the location addressed by DI register. Move SB moves 8-bit data and move SW moves 16-bit data. After the execution of move S instruction, SI and DI are automatically incremented or decremented to point to the next source and destination address depending on the value of DF flag. When DF is equal to 0, SI and DI are incremented. When DF is equal to 1, SI and DI are decremented. In case of 8-bit data move, increment or decrement is done by 1. In case of 16-bit data move, increment or decrement is done by 2. No flags are affected. CX register can be used as a count register to hold count for the elements of a string. REP instruction is used as a prefix instruction for move S instruction to handle the string. Alternately, loop instruction can be used after move S instruction for a repetition. Next is REP or repeat. This is an instruction prefix. It causes the repetition of the instruction until CX becomes 0. Example, REP move SB str1, str2, str are the strings. It copies byte by byte contents. REP repeats the operation move SB until CX becomes 0. So REP instruction is a prefix instruction which is used before the string instructions MOVS or STOS. It decrements CX register and repeats the string instruction until CX register becomes 0. The CX register contains count for the number of elements in the string. Its object code is 1111. Z is do not care bit. It may be 1 or 0. Next is again REPE, which is REPE and REPZ are two mnemonics for the same instruction. REPE or REPZ is a prefix instruction which is used for the string instruction. CMPS or SCAS, it repeats the string instruction when CX is not 0 and 0 flag is 1. The repetition stops when CX is decremented to 0 or ZF is equal to 0. REPNE or REPNZ are two mnemonics for the same instruction. REPNE or REPNZ is a prefix instruction which is often used before the string instruction SCAS. It repeats the string instruction when CX is not 0 and ZF is equal to 0. Repetition stops when CX is decremented to 0 or ZF is equal to 1. Now we will discuss some programs in the next video, like the largest number in a data array, smallest number in a data array, largest 8-bit number in an 8-bit data array, smallest 8-bit number in an 8-bit data array, sum of a series of 16-bit numbers, sum of a series of 16-bit numbers whose sum is 32-bit, block move or relocate of byte move and word move, block move using REP instruction, and first of all we'll discuss about the assembler directives. I'll end the class here. Thank you so much.